All right, Nindya, I think we're good to go ahead and get started if you want to start us out.
Okay. Halo teman-teman, selamat pagi semuanya. Terima kasih ya udah datang di acara hari ini dan semuanya on time nih jam 10 pagi. Jadi thank you for joining di event hari ini di University of Arizona Agent Training. Sebelumnya perkenalkan mungkin yang belum kenal, nama saya Nindya. Saya dari Wellspring International Indonesia Office. Jadi Wellspring sendiri kita adalah education group dari US, di mana kita mewakili banyak top university yang ada di US. Dan salah satunya adalah University of Arizona. Jadi mungkin kita sudah sering dengar ya tentang University of Arizona. Jadi memang University of Arizona ini pada saat ini menduduki peringkat top 100 university in the world. Dan University of Arizona ini juga merupakan one of the public Ivy League school in the US. Jadi ini adalah selling point yang paling strong ya sebenarnya dari University of Arizona. Jadi mungkin kalau kita ketemu student yang pengen cari top university di US, top ranking university, itu kita bisa coba tawarin University of Arizona ini karena dia masuk sebagai salah satu public Ivy League school di US. Dan University of Arizona, dia juga menawarkan beasiswa yang lumayan generous ya. Jadi beasiswa yang ditawarkan itu cukup besar, sampai dengan potongan 23.000 per tahun. Jadi potongan yang bisa didapatkan oleh student itu bisa sampai dengan 23.000 tiap tahunnya ya. Jadi dari tahun pertama, kedua, ketiga, sampai dengan keempat, sampai dengan student lulus. Kemudian University of Arizona ini juga kebetulan masuk ke list beasiswa LPDP ya. Jadi teman-teman yang mungkin ketemu student yang cari beasiswa LPDP, nah untuk yang LPDP afirmasi itu untuk University of Arizona itu masuk untuk semua jurusan. Nah, jadi buat teman-teman di sini yang mungkin selanjutnya ada inquiry student rencana mau kuliah ke US, please do not hesitate to contact me ya. Jadi untuk cari informasi apapun bisa WhatsApp ke saya atau telepon juga boleh. Atau jika mau dibantu untuk Zoom ya dengan studentnya itu juga bisa. Oke, jadi tidak perlu berlama-lama, kita akan segera dengarkan penjelasan lebih lanjut ya tentang University of Arizona dari Darby Simpson ya. Thank you. The floor is yours, Darby.
Thank you so much, Nindya. Hello. As she mentioned, my name is Darby. I'm a representative of the University of Arizona. I'm going to be doing the webinar presentation tonight. I'm super excited to tell you all about the University of Arizona and why we're such a premier destination for international students. Some housekeeping items. This webinar will be recorded, so it goes fast and there's a lot of information. So if you want to slow it down and go back and, you know, rewatch a part or, you know, fill yourself in on some information that you want to go over again, we will get the webinar recording to you to watch after the fact. So I'll do my presentation and then we'll open up the floor for a Q&A session. If you would like, you can always write your questions in it into the Q&A feature. And I'll be sure to get to them when we get to the Q&A. So with that, I will share my screen here. All right, does that look good to everyone?
Yep.
Great, thank you, Nindya. All right, so the University of Arizona. The University of Arizona is located in Tucson, Arizona, which is in the southwestern region of the US. But we have a global reach. So we have two international airports in our state and are very close to the Mexican border. So we are no strangers to international reach. We have been around for a very long time. We were established as Arizona's land grant university in 1885. So dating back pretty far there. We're also Hispanic serving institution. So this has a lot to do with our proximity to Mexico. So that means about Over 25% of our student population is Hispanic or Latino. So again, no stranger to international students, and we have a very big population of them for that reason. We also have some pretty impressive statistics and rankings. So we're a top 50 public university, and we're in the top 1% of global universities. So those are pretty impressive rankings, a big reason why we're such a destination for both domestic and international students. A brief breakdown of our student population. We have over 50,000 students, so that is quite a big school. We are very, very large when it comes to student population. You can see in the breakdown here, a vast majority of those students are going to be undergraduates. Then we've got graduates coming in at over 10,000 students, and then 7% of that, so 3,600 of those are going to be international. So a really great percentage of international students for how large of a school we are. All right, this video. So I don't think you'll be able to hear the sound, but the sound is just music. So I'll go ahead and play it and just know that you're not missing any background noise. I just think this video has a lot of really great visuals of what the University of Arizona looks like, but it also has some pretty impressive statistics. All right, so again, just some really great visuals of what it looks like to be on campus with us here at the University of Arizona. Let's see. All right, so a little bit more about Tucson itself. So we are located in Arizona, and we are a desert state. So we're located in the Sonoran Desert. So you can see over here with this little placard, we actually are very close to Saguaro National Park. So that saguaros are the big cactuses you see in the little stamp. So lots of cactus, lots of palm trees, lots of really great, beautiful weather all year round. So not really much snow, not really much of any of that weather that you'll find other states in the US. We have 350 sunny days. That definitely plays into the fact that we are a desert state. So like I said, you know, always blue skies, always sunny days here in Tucson. We are a UNESCO City of Gastronomy. We actually are the first and only UNESCO City of Gastronomy in the United States. So this has a lot to do with our very vibrant and cultural food scene. So our cuisine is very much inspired by both Native American influences and Mexican influences because of our proximity to Mexico. So that, you know, leaves us with a very rich food scene culturally. So as someone who has eaten my way around Tucson, I can definitely say that we have some of the best food I've ever had. So that's definitely something students appreciate and look forward to here in Tucson. So we have 1 million in the metro area. So we are a relatively large city. Even though we're not the capital of Arizona, we are very large. Students are going to find basically anything they need in Tucson. Also, our top five for best air quality. So we are a very nature-forward city. You know, people love to get outside. They like to hike. They like to bike. They like to golf. Pickleball is pretty popular because we have such great weather most of the year. People really love to be outside. And so, you know, our city really takes pride in making sure that the air quality is, you know, of the best quality to make sure we can all be outside all the time. And we also have an international airport. So, although it's an international airport, it's pretty small. So, if you're going to any, you know, unique destinations, you'll most likely have to drive about an hour to 2 hours north to Phoenix, which is the capital. You can see in the map over on the right-hand side where Tucson is located. So if you were to just go, you know, 2 hours north, you'd hit Phoenix. You can see our proximity to some other large US states. So proximity to Las Vegas, Los Angeles, San Diego, you know, all of those are within relatively close reach. We are neighboring states to California, so it's a pretty big US state, so students can, you know, pop over there relatively easily. And if you were to go off the map south, so downwards, that would be Mexico. So you can see how close we really are. So some of the academic colleges that your students will be able to find at the University of Arizona. You can see that we have a plethora of colleges with taking into account that we have over 50,000 students, we have to have a lot of colleges to, you know, accommodate all of those students and all of their various interests. So students are, you know, never at a loss for finding a program, finding a college that suits them. So, if any of you are familiar with the U of A already, we do have some updates and improvements, new and improved programs and such. So, just wanted to feature this slide in case any of you needed a refresher. All right, so now I'm going to get into some of our most popular subject areas. So, first being space sciences. So, at the U of A, we like to say that space is wildcat country. We have a very impressive space science department. We work very closely with NASA on several projects. It is a destination for students wanting to get into space science and, you know, physics and astronomy and all of that good stuff. So, because we have sunny days and really clear skies, because we have such good air quality, you know, it really sets us up to having a very clear picture of space. We were the first university unit to manage a mission to Mars, so that's pretty impressive, I must say. We also headquarter multiple world-class telescopes, so, you know, students in these programs are able to have access and research and study with these telescopes, which is not true for several other space science programs in the country. We also produce the largest mirrors made for use in optical telescopes. So again, we have a lab where students are able to work with professors and, you know, NASA faculty to, you know, see how these mirrors are made, participate in it, which is very cool if that is a student's interest. It's definitely the place to be. So some of the programs that can be found in the space sciences, both undergraduate, graduate, and minors, you'll see lots of engineering, lots of physics, obviously astronomy, things like that. So, moving on to climate science, the University of Arizona and Arizona itself has a very unique relationship with climate sciences because we're located in the desert. We are very much affected by the changing climate, and we do a lot of research and a lot of work to ensure that, you know, both our university, our city of Tucson, and our state of Arizona are going to be able to survive and thrive in a changing environment. We, you know, in the desert, you have limited resources, you have limited access to water. So we want to make sure that our community is able to, you know, continue to exist and have access to the resources they need as, you know, water resources change and ebb and flow. So, some impressive statistics here. We're number one in limnology, which is the study of freshwater lakes. We're number two in water resources, number 28 in earth sciences, and number 30 in ecology. So, I think those statistics really speak for themselves in relation to how impressive our climate science program really is. Here are some fun pictures I always love to show when we talk about climate science because we really do have some great facilities dedicated to the climate sciences. So over on the left, you'll see some images of the Biosphere 2. So this is essentially a ginormous greenhouse where students and faculty are able to create different environments and understand how crops and plants are going to react to a changing environment. So this really prepares us to understand how things may change as the climate changes and be prepared and able to, counteract those possibly negative changes to make sure that we're always able to thrive, essentially. It's always just really cool to see, we are in the desert. There's not necessarily a lush jungle right around the corner. So it's always fun to go into the biosphere and see such a different world than the outside world of Tucson and Arizona. So it's also open to the public. So if any of you are ever in Tucson, you can go check out the biosphere without having to be a student necessarily. So, and then over on the right, we have ENR2. So, this is our building on campus dedicated to the climate sciences and, environmental, natural resource classes. So, this building was actually modeled after the Grand Canyon and was really built to be a space that students in this program can, soak up nature while they're taking their courses. So, this courtyard is somewhere that students hang out with one another, they do homework, they catch up with their professors. There's a cafe, so maybe grab some lunch, grab a coffee. It's very much a communal space that allows students to be surrounded by nature. So, for students interested in climate sciences, these are some of the programs that can be found. So, obviously, lots of biology, environmental science, those kind of courses, but then you can also find business courses here. We've got urban and regional development and agricultural and resource economics, which is very cool to see the intersection of such a science-heavy field intersect with business. All right, and the last subject area I'm going to talk about for the purpose of this presentation, obviously we have so many other programs to choose from, but one of our most popular is our Eller College of Management. This is our business. So our business school is very prestigious and very well known around the country for being a really great business school. Not only do international students from around the world come to join Eller, but domestic students see it as a really great destination if they're interested in business. So you can see that representative in some of these statistics here. So we have a number 18 undergraduate program, a number one graduate master's in information science, sorry, program, 90% career outcomes for graduates, and number six master's in finance. So, like I said, some really impressive statistics there. For students interested in Eller, they can find basically every business program that you could ever imagine. There is no shortage for sure. All right. And then moving on. So that concludes some of our programs. Like I said, there are so many more, but those are some of the most popular for our international students. Now we're going to move on to student life and talk about a little bit what it is like to attend the U of A as a student. And then we'll get into, cost, admission requirements, scholarships, all that good stuff. So, campus life, the Wildcat Way. You can see on this slide Wilbur and Wilma. Those are our mascots. Obviously, they are Wildcats. So, As for on-campus housing, there are four housing districts located throughout campus. So, because we have so many colleges and so many students, we have to have a really large campus to accommodate all of these students and all of these buildings. So, our campus is very, very large, spans, a lot of geographic space. So we have four housing districts located all throughout campus. Within those four housing districts, we have 23 dorms. They vary significantly in cost. So students are able to really cater their housing options to their budget. We also offer living and learning communities. So these offer a really dynamic living experience where students are able to both live and learn, it's in the name, with students with common interests. So an example of this would be women in STEM. So being able to be surrounded by women who are just as interested in STEM as you can really create a very awesome community within your dorm and within your academic college. So, something I always like to mention when we talk about on-campus housing is that it's not guaranteed and it fills up very fast. So, we have around 8,000 spaces for 50,000 students. So, obviously, not all those students want to live on campus. Typically, it's just freshmen, although students of any, year can live on campus. So, they, if they would like to, but typically, it's our freshman students who are first year students, I should say, that are interested in living on campus. I would say that students applying now should absolutely submit housing requests and housing applications as soon as possible. It's possible that we're already on a wait list. If a student gets waitlisted, not a problem. It's possible that they might still be granted a on-campus living option. However, if on-campus housing is not in the cards for a student, that is no problem because we also do not have a shortage of off-campus housing that surrounds the university campus at all different prices, and living options, whether they want to live by themselves, they want to have roommates, they want to, whatever that it will look like for a student. We have plenty of options, and we actually have a page of our website dedicated to helping students find these options and research them for sure. So we are D1 and R1. Starting with D1, we're Division One Athletics. So that means that we are the best of the best and we play the best of the best. We also have 21 sports and we're in the Pac-12 conference. So right here, you can see the Arizona football stadium, which football games are definitely popular, but our basketball team is pretty standout. We actually just lost in the March Madness basketball tournament, but that's okay because we still love our Wildcats dearly. Basketball is definitely a very highly watched sport here at the Bay. So, as for R1, we are a research one institution with over $820 million of research activity, which is pretty crazy. We have research opportunities from day one. So, whether a student comes in as a first year, a transfer, a graduate student, they are always going to have access to research activity to, really deepen and develop their academic experience. We also have 535 patents and 128 startups, which really speak to, how innovative our students are at the U of A, and we really foster that here. As for success and engagement, we have over 600 student clubs and organizations. Because we have so many students, we have to have enough clubs and organizations to represent all of their unique interests. If it happens that a student is not able to find out of the 600 clubs something that they're interested in, they're always able to start a club of their own. We also have the Student Success District. So this includes things like a library, the think tank, the career development office. Really, this Student Success District is a building that is dedicated to ensuring student success in the name. So everything from, career development, help to all the way to mental health counseling. It's a very broad spectrum of resources that students are able to access via the Student Success District. We also have five campus libraries, which is pretty crazy. But like I said, campus is huge. We want to make sure that our students are, always within reach to the resources that they need via the library. So we have five different libraries. We also have over 10,000 campus jobs available. These are very, very popular with our international students because on their student visa, they're only allowed to work on campus if they choose to work throughout their studies. So, a great variation of jobs are available here. So, whether they want to work in the library or the dining hall or in on-campus Chick-fil-A, whatever it may be, they're able to cater that to, the work experience that they want for sure. The minimum wage of Arizona is $15 an hour, which is pretty competitive compared to some other US states. All right, so upon moving on to applying for admission, all of the deets everyone's been waiting for. So some deadlines that we should be looking forward to. I'm going to focus on fall of 24 for this presentation because that is the intake that we're going into. So, as for graduate, I would say that most, if not all, graduate program deadlines have passed by now. So, typically, you can see they're sometime in January, sometimes earlier. There is a slight chance that there might be a program or two that will still be, taking applications. So be sure to check in with Nindya or your Wellspring representative to see if it's possible to submit an application there. As for undergraduate, we're coming up on the deadline here pretty soon of May 1st. So it's definitely prime time to get applications in and get everything submitted in time for that deadline. The on-campus housing deadline is also May 1st, but it says here typically fills up sooner. But it always fills up sooner. So be sure to, have your students submit all of the necessary documentation and applications there if they're wanting to live on campus for sure. The I-20 request deadline is July 1st. That's a pretty hard and fast deadline. So keep that in mind for sure. We have an enrollment fee refund of July 15th. We also have a deferral deadline of August 26th, which is about 2 weeks after class start on August 19th. So everything seems really far away now, but I promise it will come up fast. So some admission requirements for the undergraduate level. I'm going to focus on first year for the purpose of this presentation. So generally speaking, if it's not a competitive program, these are the requirements we're looking at. I will get into competitive requirements on the next slide. So, 2.75 GPA, 3 years of coursework, English proficiency or exemption. You can see here on the slide all of the different ways that students can prove English proficiency or exemption. There is no SAT required. But yeah, that's the most general form of our admission requirements. I will now go on to the competitive programs. So these are going to be programs such as architecture, nursing, engineering, law, business management, economics, and fine arts. So you can see here that they have various GPA requirements spanning from a 3.0 all the way to a 3.75. You can also see that some of these programs do have competitive English proficiency scores. Over on the right-hand side of the slide, you can see what those competitive English scores are. So, slightly elevated test scores there. As for scholarships, again, this is on the undergraduate level, and I'm going to focus on first year for the point of this, but we have a Global Wildcat scholarship that is auto-awarded at time of admission. So students don't have to do anything to apply for this scholarship other than apply for the University of Arizona. And it will be based on their recalculated GPA. So you can see the breakdown here of what a student's GPA is and the award that they can expect. Same for transfer. The breakdown is going to be slightly different, but same idea. Students can renew this award During their time at the U of A, for first years, it's 8 semesters, so 4 years. Transfers, it's 4 semesters, so 2 years. As long as they maintain full-time student status and a 3.0 GPA. So, annual cost of attendance. I'm going to focus on main campus, but you can see some other costs on this slide if you're interested. So, tuition is coming in just under 40,000 US dollars. So, that is a large amount compared to, a community college. But at the University of Arizona, we really believe that you get what you paid for, and our students see a great return on the investment of attending U of A. Housing is estimated at 17,000, a little over 17,000. I would say that that's on the higher end of what students typically pay for housing. Of course, if they chose the most expensive, options, they wanted to live in a single suite, have the most expensive meal plan, they could expect to pay over $17,000. But there are definitely options for students to, cut costs in this department and, pick some more budget-friendly options here. Health insurance is required for all of our international students, so that comes in at $2,765. And then, of course, their scholarship is going to be accounted for here, so they can expect to pay anywhere from $36,000 all the way up to $59,000. So that's a breakdown of how much it will cost to attend U of A as an undergraduate student. All right, moving on to graduate. So these admission requirements are going to be very, very general. So most graduate programs are going to set their own requirements, their own standards. So it's always very important that you're checking in with Nindya or your Wellspring representative to make sure that, double check the admission requirements for your students' specific programs, because often it's going to look different depending on the program. So we can say, generally speaking, we want our graduate students to come in with a 3.0 GPA or higher. We need their transcripts, of course, and then English proficiency score or exemption. These scores are going to vary a lot, but this is a general basis. Some programs might recommend or require a statement of purpose, maybe an academic resume. GRE and GMAT is going to vary by department. And also the application deadlines are going to vary by department. So I know it's hard that I can't give you very specific, deadlines and requirements like I can for undergraduate, but this is pretty typical for all graduate programs, no matter where you are. So, cost of attendance graduate wise, main campus tuition comes in around 32,000, really 33,000 on that higher end of 32. Some programs are going to cost more. So, I know like Vet Tech, Veterinary School, Eller, I believe like architecture are all going to be a bit higher in tuition, but this is a baseline. Housing is estimated at 22,000, which again is a very high estimate. We don't see our graduate students typically spend this much on housing, but it is possible. Health insurance, again required, comes in at 2,765, bringing our grand total to 57,875. For our graduate students, the University of Arizona does not offer a scholarship for international students like we do for undergraduate students. So that is something to be aware of, that's not necessarily an option. Of course, students can find some third-party funding via, there's a ton of different scholarship websites out there in the world. It's just not something that we offer through the U of A. All right, and that is actually the end of my presentation. So I will leave you with Bear Down, which is our U of A slogan or rally cry of sorts. So the next time, if you're ever in Tucson, you say Bear Down, people will definitely know what you're talking about. So I will now let everybody into the room to be able to unmute, ask questions if you so please. If you would rather write them into the chat or the Q&A, totally fine too. Whatever works for you. So happy to answer any and all questions. Sorry, it's just gonna take me a minute to get everybody let in. So thank you for your patience. Glad we had such great turnout today.
Hello, Darby.
Hi.
Hi. Thank you for the presentations. You're doing it so really well.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. I even did a screenshot just to make me understand it better. But since we have Miss Nindya here, I think if there is any more questions, I will like just jumping into Nindya and asking for more about all the details. I also noted about the intake gonna be soon. We need to work on this. We have a school that we have pointed out that we want to tell about the University of Arizona. So thank you for your presentation. Really, really appreciate it. And Miss Nindya will talk to you soon whenever we have a chance to do with more presentations with the school. And we have a school that I think we already pointed me and my teams already know about the schools that really interested in placing the students into US. So I just would like to say thank you, Miss Derby. You're doing so good.
Yes, of course. Well, thank you for joining. It means a lot to me that you will take time out of your busy schedule to hear me talk. So, thank you. I know that that was a lot of information really fast. So, definitely reach out to Nindya if you have any questions about any of the specifics. But we also recorded the presentation. So, we'll be sure to get that out to everybody here today. So, if you want to go back and rewatch any section, you can totally do that as well. But I see another question in the Q&A asking if it is difficult for students to find part-time jobs around the campus area. We have over 10,000 on-campus jobs. Our international students have to work on campus. They're able to work up to 20 hours a week and 30 hours in the summertime. We find that our international students really love working on our campus, and there is no shortage of jobs. If a student is having a hard time finding an on-campus job, they can always reach out to ISS, which is International Student Services, and they'll be able to, or the, career office can help students get matched with an on-campus opportunity for work. So, I also see a question about Indonesian students. We do have Indonesian students. I don't know the exact number off the top of my head, but we have a close to what was it, 4,000 international students. So, definitely a lot of room there to have students from Indonesia. How are they adapting to the climate? So, I don't know if this is talking about the cultural climate or the actual like weather climate, but I can answer both. Because Tucson is such a international focused community and city that we find a lot of our international students adapt very well and are able to find their place within several cultural groups, cultural clubs, all those kind of things. As for the actual weather climate, we are a very hot but a very dry climate. So I think a lot of our students from this region of the world, they definitely appreciate the warmth. You're not running into snow or anything like that, but it is an adjustment to go from really high humidity to, a more desert climate, but nothing that our students have ever, struggled with too bad. So, hope that answers your question. I
Thank
have
you.
a question. Oh, what was that?
Thank you very much for your answer.
Yeah, of course. Did that answer it okay?
It was really well answered. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I have another question about part-time jobs. Is it possible for them to work during study outside campus area? So this is not necessarily something that students are allowed to do with a typical student visa. They're only allowed to work on campus and be employed by the University of Arizona. There are some circumstances where a student might be able to do like a research opportunity that is hosted and funded by the U of A, but might not be necessarily like on main campus. So they might be studying at a lab or a research office off campus, but it's technically still a, University of Arizona sponsored employment. So not able to just, walk into any establishment outside of U of A and get a job there, as that would possibly compromise a student's visa. Internships. Yes, we do offer several internships. So within our career development office, students are able to really get a lot of support and a lot of help with finding internships if they would like to, based on their interests and whatever subject area they're interested in. The U of A is a very well-known school and a very well-known establishment. So through our career development office, you're able to be connected with a worldwide network of companies that you could do an internship with. We have so many students throughout our very long history. So there's a lot of alumni that, love to include U of A students in their current business opportunities. So hope that answers your question. Does the U of A accept GED scores for international students? So this is going to depend on the program, I believe. So I would have to look into that and get some more information. I don't know if Nindya, you have any information you want to provide there or not.
I think for the GED is actually accepted because we also have some application from students transferring from community college, and they are actually using the GED instead of the high school diploma. So I think it's accepted.
Yeah, I imagine so. I just don't know exactly what the score is, and it will depend on the program. Like if it's a competitive program, such as business or engineering, those requirements might differ. So something to be aware of. We also have a question for graduate programs. Even though the student has graduated, and has a bachelor in the US, do students still have to submit a TOEFL IELTS score or can it be waived? Yes, if a student has a bachelor's degree in a English-speaking country, that is English proficiency in the way of method of instruction. So that is something that we accept for our graduate students for sure. Then there's a question about do graduate programs get scholarships? So no, we do not offer international graduate students scholarships from the U of A. So they would have to seek additional funding outside of the U of A. All right, do we have any other questions tonight for me? I know it's morning for most of you. All right, well, if there's no more questions, then we can go ahead and get wrapped up. Again, if you have any questions following this presentation, do not hesitate to reach out to Nindya as she can get all of your questions answered. And be sure to keep your eyes peeled for the webinar recording if you'd like to view it after the fact. But other than that, I just want to thank you all for being here today and learning more about why the U of A is such a great school and why we have so many international students here in Tucson with us. So thank you. Great. Well,
Thank you.
Nindya, you have a great rest of your day. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thank you Darby for having this session. Dan thank you semuanya yang sudah hadir di acara hari ini. Buat buat kalian yang ada pertanyaan lagi bisa langsung WhatsApp ke nomor saya ya. Mungkin kalau yang belum ada nomor WhatsApp saya di 0856 9363 4315. Coba saya ketik di kolom chat ya.
Yes, please. Thank you.
All right. I hope everybody has a great rest of your day. Oh,
Okay.
Bye, Miss. You
We
must
have
be
a
late there,
message.
right?
Yeah.
Bye.
Yes, it's definitely late here in the US.
Yeah, have a good night then, Miss.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Bye.
Have a nice rest. Enjoy the rest of the day. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye semua.
Miss Nindya, nomornya mana ya? I didn't get it.
Nomor
Oh,
saya saya tadi
here, I
my
can drop
mobile
it in the
number.
Q&A because it doesn't actually.
Yeah.
I don't know if they can see.
I cannot see. But it's okay. I think yeah. I think my team knows your number. We'll send
Okay.
you.
Miss
Here, I can
Helda
share my
dari agensi mana,
Fortress.
Miss? Oh, dari
Fortress with Miss
Fortress. Oh,
Della.
okay. Yeah, I
Yeah,
remember.
Miss Della knows you very well. Yeah, I can ask her actually. Yeah. The time we met, yeah, you brought us some coffees. But yeah,
Yeah.
I don't think I have your name card. Okay, then. Udah ya, Miss?
I
Oh
went
iya
ahead
nih
and
dia. I got it your number.
I just dropped Nindya's information to you directly in the chat.
Okay, thank you. Oh, that's why. Thank you, Derby. And also the recording, yeah.
Yes, we will send you the recording in the email soon.
Yes,
Oh, you
okay.
can watch it again.
Yeah,
Yeah,
yeah.
that'll be
Sure.
in the next
Sure,
few
that
days.
will be work. That works.
Great.
Thank you so much. Okay. Wow.
Bye-bye.